Hello and welcome to the live telecast brought to you by www.thepopper.com. We are coming to you live from Police Park. It's a wet and gloomy day today. The debut match of the Dialogue Rugby League 2016-17 all set to take place. Joining with me in commentary is Sabir. Good afternoon, Sabir.
Good afternoon, Sudarshka. It's been absolutely pouring down to kick off the new season of Dialogue Rugby League. And also you're watching this live action on Dialogue TV Channel 1 and also your mobile device on My TV. And of course, the number one sports network, thepopperay.com. And you can see the team, police are warming up at the moment. They need probably a bit more time to settle down because it's absolutely pouring down here. And you can see the man with that armband, Mushin Falil, the one who did tremendously well for the Corps last season.
And there you go. That's a shot coming to you from the Navy side. The Navy side. A revamp outfit. They have some players who have been in the side as well, and balloons and celebrations all led to start this debut game of the Dialogue Rugby season 2016-17. And also what we have today on card, a special moment, retired DIG Hafil Maso, a very celebrated son of the police. He was a double international representing the country in rugby and also in basketball as well. He will be felicitated today after his retirement, after a service of almost four decades. And the ground conditions are going to be soggy. There you go, police taking on Navy. And we are coming to you live from Police Park grounds on www.thepopper.com, Dialogue Channel 1, and also on My TV. And this will be the first of many that we will be bringing you during this season.
That's right. Udara Surya Perumal, the police captain on your left, and Roshan Ranasinghe, the veteran for Navy Sports Club, who will be playing today in the tight head position for the Sailors. And both of them actually have tremendous experience under their belt. And also you mentioned about the Hafiz Maso, Sudarshana absolutely has done a yeoman service of Sri Lankan rugby and to Police Sports Club, and his memories certainly will be blossom up when he sits as the chief guest today for this wonderful encounter.
Brilliant. Since it's not going to be very friendly for running rugby, Sabir, because of the downpour just before the game. Luckily enough, the rain has eased out a little now, so we will be hoping that it stays the same. But talk about this game as a first up game in the season, especially speaking about Navy and Police. They have their inter-defense rivalry going on anyway.
Absolutely, they do have the rivalry, but on the other hand, Sudarshan and Navy have some experience. The players have played in the last 2-3 years almost together. You can see Rishi Dharmapala, they have very good combination. Lee Kegel was outstanding in the last Super Sevens, and he was so gutted to miss out the Sri Lanka Sevens as well due to his injury. But good signs that he is fit now alongside the Stefan Gregory, the big 120kg prop forward. So there are so much experience as well as youth coming into the Sailors. And on the other hand, Sudarshana in the Police, but they were really suffering in the last year because they had some good numbers in the likes of Shahro Fernando, Chamara Dabare and Bilal Hassan and Riza Mubarak, but unfortunately they could not do well. But this time they have the experienced coach, of course former Police Cup captain, which is Sudhat Sampath, who led the Sri Lanka under 27s team for the first ever Asian title. He has once again a tremendous experience, but so much responsibilities lie under his shoulders.
Definitely. He also was in charge of the women's team at the Asia Rugby Sevens as well. Now, talking about the Navy side, like you said, they have a lot of experience, but it's interesting to know Lahir Huera, the boy from Karnagara, will be debuting in this game as a second center. And there you go, the match officials, Adra Rankudge, the main referee, and the assistant referees, all the ARs, Sarad Madugal and Pradeep Indika. And for the first time in the club rugby season, TMO, the television match official, will be available, and Vimal Pereira will be taking on that responsibility. And initiative brought forward by Papare.com, a proposal brought forward by Papare.com in order to lift up the standards of rugby in this country, Sabir.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks for SLRFU, Sri Lanka Rugby Football Union, which is now known as Sri Lanka Rugby, and also the Referee Society for understanding that and joining together to bring the TMO coverage. So it's still pouring down here at the Police Park. You can see on your screen, Referee Rankudge having words with his assistant referees. And that is the Navy bench, and spectators in the sense stand is pretty much getting filled up by the police and the Navy supporters.
There you go. That's what they are all playing for. The Dialogue Club Rugby League, the coveted prize. 8 teams will be battling out for in the season. It's going to be a fierce battle. Last year round, Kandy Sports Club were absolutely dominant. 14 games unbeaten in the season, and no one could challenge them last time around.
Absolutely, yes. But Sean Vijayasinghe did mention that at the preview of Sudarshana, they are not underestimating any team, even though they have been the defending champions. But I'm sure that there is a much hope from Kandy Sports Club, because in terms of their supporters, there's no doubt Nitavale is going to be an absolute carnival atmosphere when they play. But also, on the other hand, Sudarshana, CHNFC, their first home game, they are playing as an away game, so they'll be playing tomorrow at Nitavale Grounds with the defending champions. But coming back to this game, things are pretty settled for the kickoff. We are just under 3 minutes left for the scheduled kickoff time at 4 p.m.
Definitely on. Now talking about, here you go, this is the points table last time around. Kandy SC, 14 games played, 14-1. Absolutely dominant performance. Havelock's coming second best. CR in the third position. But look at Navy and Police. Both these teams ended up winning 7 games. The only difference was that Navy managed to draw 1 game, whereas Police lost 7 as well. So this time around, both teams have had mixed fortunes last time around, but they will be looking to put in a good start in the debut game itself, Sabir.
That's right. Look at the try numbers. 85 tries out of 14 games. That makes a champion difference, isn't it, Sudarshana?
Definitely on. So this time around, Police would be looking to put in a good performance. They're playing in front of their home crowd. A lot of pride goes into this affair. Two teams will now be introduced to the chief guest. That is a retired AIG Hafil Mazo, who is the chief guest of the event. And Nizam Jamaldeen will be accompanying him. Police team first to take the field. And also, interestingly, from the news that we've received, looking at the team cards, Diran Varnakulasuriya has made a comeback to rugby after laying out last year. He last played for Havelock Sports Club, but he has decided to come in for Police Sports Club this time around. He will be wearing the number 8 jersey, so a hard comeback for Varnakulasuriya.
There you go, Police Sports Club. We have some experience. Achila Ferreira at number 2, Udara Jayasekara, another big bulky prop forward, and Romesh Acharya, the experienced campaigner who has playing decades for Police Sports Club, along with the captain in number 5 jersey, Udara Surya Perama. And also Radhisha Seniratna was outstanding. He can play loose forward anywhere. And he was actually a scrum half who converted into a loose forward.
Well, of course, there, Sabir, and Diran Varnakulasuriya, like we mentioned, occupying the number 8 position for a return side. And also Muhammad Abzal, the scrum half, Sandesh Jayavikrama, Roshan Silva, Mushin Falil, the great forward Police last season, would be looking to cap his performance up this time around. And he has the experience of Chola Susanta on the outside. Reza Rafaidin, the youngster who impressed in the under-20s, will be wearing the Wing 3 jersey, and Rajita Sansosi, the fullback for Police SC.
Yeah, good mix of combination in the back row. Looks solid, as well as the back three quarters looks solid with experience. But Mushin Falil and Chula Susanta combining in that pivotal center position. It'll be interesting, but there we can't probably see too much kicking today. But let's have a look at the Navy Sports Club. Kasum De Silva, Dulanjan Vijayasinghe, of course, played Sri Lanka last year. And Roshan Ransinghe, the captain in the tight head. Supun Pieris and Satya Ranatunga. Satya Ranatunga, of course, can play in the front row as well. He's another big ball carrier. And we have Danushka Pereira, another Sri Lankan player, alongside Kanchana Pereira and Nivanka Prasad, the up-and-coming number 8 for Navy Sports Club. Rishi Dharmapala, the lippy halfback, and Chanaka Chandimal have so much experience. Budhima Piratna in the wing. He has played for Sri Lanka under 20 as well. And Lee Keagle and Lahiru Herath. And experienced Jinusha Chaturanga in the number 14 wing position. And Thilina Weerasinghe, the man to watch out for. The man who actually scored the highest number of points last season, will be the man to watch on today's game. We'll see how much kicking duties he's going to do.
Absolutely spot on. When you said there's going to be a lot of kicking, Tel Navira Singh is going to come into the forefront of this game because his territorial kicking is going to be absolutely important in the context that the wet ball is going to play a major part in this game. But Sabir, interesting point. There you go, the replacement for police. We have Danish Dissanayake, Randhir De Silva, Danish Kedrisuria, Bajit Fawmi, schoolboy who was...
Absolutely, Sudarshan. He was an interesting candidate. Good to see that he's in the bench. He was outstanding for Zaire College.
Absolutely. And Chanaka Harishchandra, Kasun Rajakarno, Chanaka Bandara, and Sandamin Rodrigo for police, but a stronger Navy. Replacement set, I would say Stefan Gregory, 120 kilogram, Charit Silva, Nisal Deshita, Matis Satichand, Chatra Delshan, and Suranga Pushpakumar coming in the second half. He's going to be absolutely crucial. And Supun Delshan and Salia Handapan would consist in the Navy bench.
That's right, that's 90% of Isipathana players who played last year in the winning team as well, Sudarshan. But we'll see how much game time they are going to get. Because at the look of the weather condition, it's not the many players going to be get early tiredness, especially with these conditions. But as you can see on your screen, it's really pouring down here.
The team you can see, white and blue stripes, is police. But interestingly enough, Navy also have opted to go for a white and blue stripe. The only thing differentiating the both teams are that Navy has a blue part on their arms, on their shoulders rather. So it's going to be quite difficult this time around to spot these two players. So the referee might take a decision. There you go, the referee checking out another player. The referee might take a decision to get the players to turn their jerseys around and wear it.
But there's another one difference, Sudarshan. Navy wearing white stockings, but as the game go, when they got into the mud, they're all going to look like a same team.
Definitely. So there will be a call made. One team is going to have to change the jersey. They will have to wear it the other way around. But seems like police is opting to do that.
And it's time both teams.
There you go. Take a look at the sky. It's really gloomy here. This rain doesn't look like it's going to stop anytime soon. Luckily enough for all the rugby fans, rain or shine, we are going to play our rugby. Except for the fact that if there is thundering and lightning close around, then we will be closing off the game. But luckily, so far there hasn't been any thunder or lightning, so it's safe to say that we will take on. It's going to be a muddy, messy game, Sabir.
Without a doubt, it is going to be. It's going to be like pretty much forwards game, I assume. But we'll see. The weather doesn't prevent some running game, and we have some good numbers in the pavilion. And here's the team introduction. There's the man on your screen, the chief guest, retired DIG, Mr. Marso, wishing for his team. And I think police team will wear the jerseys inside out, because both teams looks pretty much similar, like Sudarshan mentioned early on. There's number 12, Mushin Falil, the great wall of police rugby. You must say he was outstanding last season in terms of his defensive work rate. And here's the Navy team, Roshan Ranasinghe, Stefan Gregory on number 16, and Lee Keagle, number 7, Geta Pereira. And that's the team introduction for you. Also joining Zia Zahar. And it's not the perfect conditions, but it's going to be an interesting game anyway. So unfortunately, we cannot see the police players' numbers because they have changed their jerseys inside out, as you can see. But anyway, it's going to be a very brown or chocolate very soon as the players go onto the ground.
There you go, balloons released, and everything is set for this game to take off. Do pardon us, the commentators, if we miss out on the police team. because the numbers are not going to be visible and all these boys are going to look really muddy as the game progresses. But luckily enough, the starting 15, we will try and spot them for you. And absolutely brilliant. And I hope all our viewers, whoever you're joining in with us on Dialogue TV, My TV, and also on www.thepapari.com, we are absolutely thrilled for this rugby season. It's kicking off in a wet and muddy day, but it's going to be a bright season going ahead.
And we are going to have a 2 minute silence for the late Visharada Amaradeva, who passed away. And we'll be having 2 minutes silence.
There you go, a 2 minute silence for in respect and honor of the great musician Visharada Amaradeva, who has passed away, and will be his funeral will be held today. There you go, your referee for today, Anuran Kunke. Navy will be kicking off the proceedings. Here we go, all set to kick off the first game of the Dialogue Rugby League. Navy kicking off the proceedings. Not very cleanly collected, but retains position, police. The skipper deciding to do the dirty work. Abzal with the kick. Indication of what's to come this game, Sabir, we'll be seeing a lot of kicking.
That's a pretty decent start. As you can see, the weight ball did not... fixing to those hands of the second row forward on that occasion. But what a lovely kick from Mohammed Abzal, starting off that occasion, putting the pressure inside the 22 meter, and he just made a pitch of a box kick. But still Navy, Dulanjana Vijayasinghe, the man to put the throw in. They still have the position. Early set pieces are always vital, Sudarshana.
Definitely the first scrum, first line out is going to be absolutely important. But a good line out there, Satya Ranatunga comes crashing through. Big run from the big man there, Ranatunga. But Navy lose possession of the ball, so that'll be the first scrum that we will have. Navy showing early signs of a wet ball, Sabir. They did not control the ball in that ruck.
Well, Sudarshana, we might going to see more of this coming, more of knock-ons and forward passes due to the wet ball condition here. But Navy showing early on some big runners coming into the game. We saw Satya Ranatunga making a yard or two, and we'll see how police are going to capitalize this scrum.
So police in white and Navy in stripes,
and of course this coverage brought to you on www.thepapari.com. also you're watching this live on Dialogue TV channel 1, and of course on My TV on your mobile device, as Mohammed Abzal, former Kingswood player, feeds the scrum, and some good pressure.
Brilliant pressure from Navy. It's always important that you send the message clear in your first scrum itself, and Navy does it absolutely well. Richie Dharmapala feeding off to his forwards. Navy is looking to keep the ball close to them. Nivanka Prasad now. He was an absolute revelation for Navy Sports Club last season. for his good performance. He was he earned his first national call-up last year as well. Chandimal now sends it out to Dulanjana. Dulanjana still driving. Good drive there. Earning meters. Dinesh Chandimal. Not a very good pass by Richie. Not a very good area as well. I beg your pardon. Tanak Chandimal. Commonly known as Mia. Dinesh Chandimal is recovering from an injury. He's not part of the Zimbabwe tour as well.
And here we go. We are going to see the second scrum of today's game. As Achala Pereira setting things in the middle of the scrum. His opposite number, his former teammate Dulanjana, Vijay Singha. They both in fact played the Sri Lanka 15s last year. Good pressure once again. Good push by Navy Sports Club, but good take on the other hand to secure the ball position.
What a return for Dhiren Vadarakulasuriya. Two scrums. He was in a very difficult position both times, but police now opting to kick. Tilna Vijay Singha with Sekua hands there. He has numbers on the outside. Good collection by Dinesh Chaturanga. Achala with a cover-up tackle, but held well. Dharmapala now. Navy is committing good numbers into their rucks, Sabe. Although the counter-attack is very effectively coming through. Dulanjana once again through the middle.
Pretty decent run on the occasion. Here we go. Chandimal sending out to the lock forward.
Looks Supan like Peris. Supan Peris, the man. He didn't collect it the first time, but managed to control the ball finally. Navy now building faces.
You can see how flat is their attacking line because you can't form really deep, but what a lovely step. Chandimal almost sneaked through. He's capable of doing that. Navy still with the position.
Chandimal to Tilina. Tilna Vijay Singha secured well. Quick ball coming out. The skipper goes into battle. Rana Singha will be penalized there. Yes, he is penalized. Holding on the ball, says the referee.
Absolutely brilliant turnover by Radhish Seniratna. This is the man we were talking about. So good. Using his lower center of gravity. And look at this. Going into the contact. And he's coming as a tackle assistant on that occasion. And using the lower center and holding on to the ball. Absolutely brilliant play.
Radhish Seniratna right on the money. He's starting his new season exactly where he left off. Such a workhorse. And we did have these conversations, Abir. He tends to get penalized for trying to do that because it's such a marginal technique that you need to have, but executing it to perfection in that point there.
In the meantime, Mohammed Hafil Masr, retired DIG, was a felicitated here in the pavilion. That's the turnover we are talking about. Superb lower center of gravity. And he's zooshing his shoulder power. And here comes Navy once again. Budhima Piratna going into contact straight away.
Unfortunately, during the replay, police lost possession in the line out resulting from that penalty. So getting Navy a chance to get out of jail. Satya Ranatunga, strong lad. His feet and Nivanka Prasad makes another thundering run. And however, Navy Sports Club losing position again. Unfortunate for them. And talking about Radish's turnover there, the brilliant thing that you need to make note is that his feet does not touch the ground, nor does his arms, which is the right way to do what he did, Sabir.
Absolutely brilliant. And also you can see the intentions very clear by Navy Sports Club. They are trying to make two or three faces from their forwards and they are trying to wide run, especially with their three quarters, getting Lee Keagle into act. And that's a big number three. Rana Singha, the captain, going into contact and lovely offload to number eight, Prasad.
On the far side of the field, we have a player all down and medic could deaden into him. Referee decides to continue with the play. Seems like it's the number 23 for Navy. Nisal Deshata. beg your pardon. That's Dinesh Chaturanga, number 11.
He's the experienced man. I'm not sure. Maybe whether it's a HIA test, head injury assessment.
Looks like a blood vein injury. He's holding his nose. So they will get to have a replacement player coming in for him. Sali Handapangoda.
Well, you can't ask a better replacement. Sali Handapangoda, who played for the Tuskers Sevens team. And that's a knock-on from Dulanjana Vijayasinghe. Handapangoda with his lovely shining orange boots. Scored plenty of tries in the concluded Asia 7 series. And that's a free kick. Early engagement, says referee Ran Kodge. Navy showing some intensity, trying to turn over. They did turn over the previous two scrums. Taken quickly, sensibly so. Udaragayan going into contact.
Good block tackle by Navy. Driven back. The ball carrier was Udara Jayasekhar this time.
That's Sanjesh Jayavikrama, St. Peter's captain in the last season. Under pressure, did remarkably well on that occasion.
So for all of you who are joining in with us now, we're coming to you live from Police Park, wet and soggy conditions. We're coming to you live on www.thepapra.com, Dialogue TV Channel 1, and also on my TV as well. It's the first game of the season, and we have plenty more to come talking about tomorrow. Tomorrow, Havelock Sports Club will be taking on Air Force Sports Club in Air Force Sabir. It's going to be a tense affair.
That's right, and defending champions Candy will take CHNFC at Nitavela Grounds. And we also have to mention that TMO facility is also available in this encounter. And the throw is not straight this time by the experienced campaigner Achila Pereira.
It's going to be a difficult task for the hookers, I feel for them, because when the ball gets wet, it's difficult to lob that ball in. So the number 4 throw is going to be difficult. Number 6 is out of the question, especially with rain pouring down like this. You can't resort to number 2 as all the time as well, because the opposition will try and guess you out. So difficult condition for the hookers, because if they don't get it right, the next up is a scrum, and the more scrums that you play at, the more tired you're going to go get the first row, especially Sabir.
That's right, Navy. So far, so good with their set pieces. Also in the scrum. And here you go, Mohammed Abzal feeding it. Could not control this time. Great bit of footwork by Rishi Dharmapala. Reza Rafaid in with the ball. And he puts his boots. He can also kick at the uprights. Here goes Shandimal.
Another very good kick by Reza. It was in a dangerous area. They put it in a dangerous area. Buddhima Pieratna deciding to run across this field to the other side. Navy, they're playing on the territorial game. They're very happy to kick it. Not a good clearance, but they managed to get rid of that.
Playing really sensible rugby by Navy. They're not going into much as face-by-face play. What is interesting is that Navy still did not manage to come into opposite red zone. So as Police Sports Club, the game is pretty much played in between 10-meter mark and between the center line and the 22-meter mark, or in other words, center field. Navy line out this time.
Interestingly, Nisal Desh is taking on the throwing duties, but yet again, not straight, says the referee. So both the hookers, both the number twos, not turning out to be a very good day for them.
I think referee could have given the benefit of the doubt, especially concerning the weather condition, and there's not really a contest on that line out. But anyway,
there go referee Ran Kodge deciding otherwise.
He's more closer than us here in the commentary box. And yet again another scrum. It's only 12th minute running here. And we have seen plenty of set pieces so far.
Wonderful Surya breaking out from the back again. Sets up a good one this time. Abzal deciding to kick it from the base. Nope. Tried to collect the ball on there. Piyaratna now on the charge. Sends it out to Dharmapala. Skipper Rana Singha goes in but tackled well. Pressure coming in from police. Dharmapala has options on either side. Decides to go from the middle. Danushka Pereira, aka Goethe, the man who ran through the middle. And the referee has been penalized the police team for hands in the ruck.
First real opportunity, Sudarshana, to go for the 3 points. I'm not sure, they're still thinking. Looks like Rishi Dharmapala going to take the tap. Interesting.
Interesting indeed. There you go. They're quite confident of their forwards. Skipper Rana Singha going into the charge. Can they score? Will this be the first TMO reference, Sabir?
Dharmapala once again using a short pass to the support player. Good defense coming in.
Referee playing a knock-on advantage. Penalty again. Referee not indicating what it was for. Satya Ranatunga going in. Reaches out and claims a try. And has the referee awarded that try?
Looking at the touch judges where they're moving, it looks like a try.
There you go, he awards the try.
So the first points on the board on the 13th minute.
Will be interesting to take a look at that replay. We thought maybe, just maybe, there was double movement when Satya Ranatunga scored that try. Referee Ron Koto obviously did have the option of checking with the TMO about that try, but decided he was in a better place to award that try. So Navy scores the first points of the rugby season, and Tilna Vijay Singha, the man who scored the most points last year round, making no mistake. So 7 points to nil. Navy, the first team to score the first try.
That's right, Tilna Vijay Singha, the man on screen, and what a year he had. 146 points scored last season.
There you go, that's the reverse angle. That's the reverse angle brought to you from our very able production crew. Satya Ranatunga takes a quick tap, reaches out. There you go, double movement. Take a look at that. So
he was tackled and he has to release the ball because the player is holding his knees on the ground. Anyway, Navy with the early points, and we are heading into more action as police take the restart.
Police playing advantage. They will be looking to counter the score of police for the first time in the Navy territory, but has been turned over. Not a very good kick. Falls in no man's land. Can police collect it? Nobody wants it. Police now with the chance. They have numbers on the outside. Around the corner, try scored. What a comeback by Police Sports Club. This is what we exactly look forward to. Equalize. Dream start for the captain. Udara Surya Peruma, the try scorer, ran in on the outside and he scored the try. Beautiful comeback from Police. It all started from a very bad kickoff for Richie Dharmapala, kicking into no man's land, but finally Police collecting and touching down.
It's not really easy to kick the box kick, especially the ball is wet and the condition because your boots are also wet, so you are having some extra weight on it. So he could not execute that kick, but what a counter attack by police to put the deficit onto 2 points, 7 points to five with the conversion to come. And Rajesh Sansoni, the left foot kicker.
Sansoni now has a chance to equalize. And what a brilliant kick that is. Unfortunately, did not make the distance.
Just an inch short, I would say, Sudarshan. Here's the try. This is how it came. Brilliant piece of hands coming. And then lovely pass. Just draw and pass.
Udara Surya Peruma, the police keeper, he would be very satisfied at the way they've responded. So 5 points to seven. Police back in this game.
Here you go. As you can see, how good is that? The captain is playing as the number five, lock forward, and he's in the corner. Very good awareness where the ball bounces.
Navy restart. Collected cleanly by police. Police will be revamped now, this time around.
Sandesh Jayavikrama puts a thumping up and under. And looks like a penalty coming in. I'm not sure who was the culprit on that occasion. Referee Ran Kotge.
Assistant referee has pointed something out. And he is... there go number four. Satya Ranatunga seems to be the culprit. Referee having a word with Ranatunga and also the captain. And he will take play where the ball bounce out. So... police in a favorable position. We will definitely see if police opt in to kick the ball out, play the territorial game. They've gotten 5 points on the board. Brilliant kick to touch there, Sabir.
I'm sure without a doubt the confidence is high now by the Copes. And Sansoni, he just missed an early conversion. Just by an inch, I would say. He had the direction. And looking at this kick into touch, it sounds a pretty decent one. So police once again into the opposite red zone. Navy have to keep their heads high. Here we go, Achala Pereira. Skipper could not hold on to the ball, but still the ball is with the police. And it was sent into touch.
Early points that have been scored in this game is going to be absolutely crucial, Sabir, because as the game wears on, it's going to be very muddy. It's not very good conditions for running rugby. So points that are being scored earlier on in this game is going to be crucial in the fact that the players will be tired going into the game. They're going to be extra tired, especially because of these conditions.
Absolutely, indeed. And Achala Pereira is holding his ankles. And his elbow. Here's Dulanjana Vijayasinghe, his opposite number. Once again, it's not going well, especially with the current weather condition. But Navy still with the ball. Chandimal, in fact, it's still in a Virasinghe who puts that thumping up and under. Very good kick, but unfortunately, police swinger fumbles. He just took his eye out of the ball.
There go, making the cardinal error of taking his eye off the ball. There was Sandesh Jayavikrama for police. I beg your pardon, that was Rohan Silva for police, who could not collect that ball cleanly. Now Navy would be looking to put some pressure here.
Where is
Devanka Prasad? Beautiful break. Tackled by Sandesh. Satya Ranatunga goes in. He's held up. Oh, interesting call there. For a moment, we thought that the penalty was given Navy way, but then the referee opted in to change his hand. So, Sathya Ranatunga guilty of not releasing the ball, but how about that from Radish Senaviratna yet again arriving there. Take a look at this one. Sathya Ranatunga goes into contact. Radish Senaviratna going in there. Beautiful stuff. He's not releasing the ball. Clearly, Senaviratna was on top of that.
It's not the first time he have done it in this game. It's the second time. Such a lovely body position coming into breakdown. Like I said, using his lower center of gravity like a flash. Doesn't matter big man or small man, his opposite number who he is. But what a service he has done.
Sabir, interestingly enough, this is a player who has played scrum of half his career. Just made the conversion. Intercepted by Danush Kagerta. The lineouts have been nippy work by Sansoni.
There comes Mushin Fali with his first touch. And Feliz now working the ball. And there's a speedster Reza Rafaidin, but unfortunately called for a knock-on. Perhaps it's a forward pass. We did mention at the beginning, we are going to see a number of knock-ons and forward passes. And it's still raining here at the Feliz Park. As you can see on the replay, Mushin Fali sending it to Chula Susanta. And Sansoni is that pass. It's slightly forward. And as a result, we have another scrum. And
lineouts have been a problem. Both teams struggling to get that ball out to their locks. However, Navy have been very settled when it comes to scrumming, Sabi. They are a very good drilled unit. Dinush Chaturanga going into contact. He's back from the blood bin. Chanak Chandipa spots a gap, goes through. But he's been tackled by police. Referee playing advantage to Navy. Dinush Chaturanga now. Goes into contact. Dulanjana coming through the middle. Still on his feet. Strong lad. Still going, Dulanja. Rajesh Senaviratna arrives there yet again, but he's a little late this time. Good charging work by the police keeper. Good rush defense by Supun there. Can the cops see out this charge from the sailors? Oh, pass to nowhere. Luckily enough, he managed to pass it back. Sailors now on their sixth phase. Dharmapala decides to kick the ball out. And that time, Sandesh Jayavikrama, Rohan Silva deciding to call Mark.
I'm not really sure whether that's the right decision by Rishi Dharmapala. Put the ball into out of position. But here goes Buddhima Piratna. What a lovely step. Buddhima Piratna made almost 40 meters and a lovely offload to the big prop forward Ranatunga. Looks like a turnover. Yes, referee Rankotke playing advantage. It's all happening here. I just mentioned Rishi Dharmapala's decision making was right, but it doesn't matter because Buddhima Piratna, he made the ball position another 10 meters further with his beautiful run.
Absolutely spot on, Sabir. What a good offload that was. Straight into Ranatunga, but Ranatunga not managing to control that ball and losing it out. But still a pressure scrum coming in police way. They haven't had very good luck with Navy when it comes to scrum. There, look at that. Brilliant run and lovely little offload. Good awareness by him to know where his big man, big support is coming from. So everything happening here, Sabir.
So Navy leading 7 points to 5. And we are into the 26th minute. And we have an injury.
I think Achille Pereira is the man on the ground. They're icing his head.
Navy pretty much playing with position. I think so far they had the 70 to 30 position. They had territorial advantage as well, but when Navy scored through Satya Ranathunga, police hit back immediately after with the restart, with courtesy of their captain Udara Surya Perma, the lock forward, but he was finishing in style, playing in the far right wing. There's Mohammad Afzal. And if you're wondering why police don't have their jersey numbers, they're wearing inside out, because both police and Navy jersey just looks the same. And if you're joining in just now from anywhere, any part of the world, very good evening. But the here the weather is not so good. And we welcome you on the Dialogue TV Channel 1, also thepapri.com, Sri Lanka's number one sports hub, and of course on your mobile platform, MyTV.
Yeah, we're going now. Speaking about the weather, like you absolutely rightly mentioned, it's a very wet and muddy conditions underfoot. Prior to the game, a few players did request their stud boots to be brought into the ground. Didn't want the Kurusuria. This time around, he has a better scrum to work with. And joining with me, a man who's beaten by the weather, Shanaka Amarasinghe. Welcome, Shanaka.
Thanks, Sudarshan. It's a pretty miserable day, and exploiting that miserable conditions, going over for the try is Lee Keagle. So Navy extending their leads from the 2 points to 7 points with the conversion to come. And this is really a battle of attrition, isn't it, Sudarshan? You can't really play any sort of fast-flowing rugby in these conditions. You just got to take the chances that come to, and he just profited from that knock-on.
Absolutely spot on, Shanaka. This game especially will be fought right at the front by the two packs, and looking at the conditions so far, there have been a number of knock forwards, forward passes, and also the line-outs for both teams haven't gone very well. Torrid conditions for rugby, to be honest. Players might be quite happy that the sun is not there, but this rain is not doing them any favors here. Tilna Veerasinghe, the man who managed to collect the highest number of points last season, was good with his initial kick and adds two more to his account already. So Navy 14 points, 2-5. There you go, the replay.
It was a good move from Diran Vandakulasuriya off the back, but it's not a great pass. Had to take it in front of his face. And the knock forward kicked through easily by Lee Keagle, and it's a poacher's try. You've got to be alert to those situations, and you know, just exploited it better than anyone else.
Absolutely spot on. Now, police needs to look at getting back onto that scoreboard. They did it the first time around when Navy scored. Their counter was good. They scored straight away. And you saw the momentum going up police way. They need to reach back again.
Nivanka Prasad with the big bust up the middle of the kickoff. He's a man that I'm expecting a lot from this season. Nivanka Prasad has been excellent for Navy. Good up and under. Questions as to whether there was somebody in front of the kicker, but boot to ball was the way to collect that one, and Navy have done well. That's a good tactic in these conditions. Just put the high bomb and chase it hard. But police have managed to come away with this and secure the ball. Radhisha Seniwaratna takes it into contact. And now police have turned it over. Navy coming at them again, and now another turnover ball by the looks of things. No, Navy have managed to keep this. Running onto the ball hard from short conditions. Another little step. Nice offload and a nice interception there from police. And cleared well in the end from the base.
Reese fighting that time, deciding to kick the ball. Dinesh Chaturanga decides to put the ball to boot, but it's kicked full out, so The referee will be bringing the action back. Like you mentioned, Nivanka Prasad Shanaka has been an absolutely brilliant player. Has been an absolutely brilliant player last season, and he did get his debut call up as well for the national team because of his play up. How much are you expecting from him this season?
Well, I think he's got to improve his game in the sense of being an all-round number eight. Sudarshan, he's a good ball carrier, he's an excellent ball carrier, but in terms of turnovers and making sure he reads the game well from that base of the scrum, I think is where he needs to improve. That's a good line out from Police. They'll do well not to play too much rugby in this part of the field. Put it into the corners and attack that Navy line out. That's exactly why I was saying that Diran Mandakulasuriya had to take it off his bootlaces. He doesn't look happy at the quality of the pass. And that's going to be the problem as we continue.
We've seen plenty of that, and we are going to see plenty.
Well, that's the problem, isn't it, Sudarshan? Diran there was running away from the ball. He was running laterally. Catch all the sporting news on thepaparoi.com. Sri Lanka's number one sports hub on all your platforms. Facebook, YouTube, SoundCloud, Twitter, Instagram. Everything you want, you've got it on any platform. Good move from Police at the back of that, from Navy rather, at the back of that scrum, but coughing the ball up again. It's loose and it's swiveling around like a bar of soap everywhere. Now Navy come up with it. It's a real struggle to hang on to the ball. There's certainly hands in that ruck all over the place. But the referee has come back for a knock on before that.
While you were speaking about Nivanka Prasad, you did mention the fact that you'd like for him to improve when it comes to turnovers. And talking about turnovers, we have a master of that art in the Police side, Radhisha Senaratna, already. But he turned over about three rucks and absolute ball positioning. Hands in the ruck was the call, but then earlier on, they had lost the ball forward. Navy definitely has the more experience front pack, basically, and they've dominated the scrums. We'll see what Police will be able to do this time around. No pressure there.
Good ball out from Richie Dharmapala, but once again the ball lost in contact by Navy. It's the same thing they did last time with good possession. And now Diran Mandakulasuriya takes it forward. This is better from Police. This is Achari game. And again turned over. So knock forwards from both teams. Police are not able to put that turnover ball to good use. They've got to attack narrow, Sudarshan. They're trying to spread this too much. It's very important for coaches in these conditions to prepare for wet weather games. They need to know exactly what the game plan is going to be when the weather is wet. And it doesn't seem that either of these teams have prepared for that.
Definitely, Shanaka, with the club league moving on to the latter part of the year, we know this is the time that we get the monsoon rain, so you got to have that in your arsenal. You got to have a plan in case it rains. What are you going to do? And like I mentioned earlier on, free kick going in early, says the referee. So Police with a chance to get out of jail now.
Mohammed Absol, Police now with a little bit of wind in their sails. Diran thinks about picking and going, but sensibly keeps it for someone else with a better body position. And this is where Police need to make sure they keep it tight. Achala Pereira using all that experience, and unfortunately, just as you thought he was going to go to ground, throws the 50-50 ball. And here is it, kicked through once again, but the Police will be called back for that knock forward. So this is where discipline is going to come in. You've got to play the phases, Sudarshan. There's no excuse for that, and these guys are experienced players. They should know that by now.
Absolutely spot on there. There was no necessity for Achala to try and offload that ball. Radhisha was never going to collect that. He was never ready to collect that. There goes Ansori sending it out. Achala crashing through the middle. All they had to do was to go down and recycle that ball, like Shanaka mentioned, but deciding otherwise. What, like I mentioned, what Police needs to do is they need to build on phases, at least 4 to 5 phases, and then look to swing the ball out. which is not going to be very easy with these conditions.
Another very good scrum from the Navy. Richie Dharmapala has given good ball out again. Dinu Sachaturanga is chasing hard on this one. Well taken in the end by Rajita Sanzoni. That's a good ball from Police out to Musin Falil. Mohammed Absal behind his back to Reza Rafaidin, but the referees ruled that it's gone forward. I thought that might have been a harsh call. A behind the back pass. So if it goes, can you put a behind the back pass forward is the question, Sudarshana. I guess you can, but let's look at it here.
You know, the law now is if your hand is not going forward, it's not a forward pass, but can be interpreted in many ways, but the referee decided that it traveled forward. Unfortunate, the harsh call, I would also say.
But again, silly option for Mohammed Abzal. All he needed to do was pass that traditionally, and Rafaidin was away. That's a good crash. Good technique from Navy in these conditions. Melder. Good behind the game.
Good defensive work there by the cops. But Nivanka Prasad, unfortunate, they could not offload it properly. Sansoni now puts the ball to Boot, goes straight into Buddhima Peeratna's hands. The assistant referee stops the game for foul play. Straight away his flag was up. Who will be the culprit this time around? Seems like a sailor is going to be in trouble.
Looks like he's calling a shoulder charge on Roshan Ranasinghe, but just a penalty, so that's good to see all 15 staying on the field. Sansoni will go for touch. It's just a few minutes before halftime, Sudarshan. It's vital that they score and stay in touch with Navy here. They can't overhaul them before halftime, but they really need to stay in touch.
Absolutely, yes, because there you go. That's a replay. Nevanka Prasad, good run, but the offload wasn't clean. And Sansoni decided to put the ball to Boot. Peeratna.
That was where the incident happened, I think, off the ball. Just a charge on Sansoni. Here we are back now live. Police with a vital line out, Achala Pereira. We'll need to make sure he gets this right. They've gone short, which is sensible. Ramesh Acharige is an excellent line out jumper. They fake, go to the front. And now they will want the phases to be built up. Absal. Nice bust straight on the angle.
Mohsin Falil, the great wall of police. He's had a wonderful season last time around.
Achala Pereira with a nice angle run. This is where they need to keep it in hand. Diran Vandakula Surya, so much experience, keeps it close. Police will do well to keep attacking the line like this. Not move it too far wide of the breakdown. Massive hit. And Reza Rafaidin is all by himself on the touchline. And it was a good slowing down of the ball by Lee Keagle, where he entered the ruck from the side or through the gate. We'll have to wait and see. But again, Police didn't need to run this wide.
There you go, those passes are what we're talking about. Police not needing to take that risk. They need to play it closer. Sansoni was in a gap, but then it was always going to be difficult for Mushin with the pressure coming in to send that ball out, especially with the conditions. However, Police still have a chance with the line out, and a good one at that.
Good quick ball from Police. They've gone to the center of the field. Danushka Pereira making a nuisance of himself. So good in these tight games, Danushka. Absol again, Acharya does well to keep it in hand. Needs some support. Picked up and drive forward from Udara Jayasekara. More pick and go from Diran Mandakulasuriya. This is better from Police. Absol needs to make the decisions here. And he makes another bad one, I would say. Gives it to the big man.
Fortunately, he was stationary collecting that ball. Not running into the ball, but Police still with a chance.
And now they have some momentum, but great line speed from Navy. Really rushing up nicely. Here's Diran. Keeps it in hand nicely. And they might have been going backwards, but doesn't matter. Absol, long ball out. This is where the forwards really need to come through.
Chula Susanta sends it out to Varna Kulasuriya. Varna Kulasuriya to the captain, Udara.
Excellent work there from the defense. I think it was Zinusa Chaturanga that came up out of his defensive line. Vital tackle.
Chaturanga needs to roll away. And referee decides that he made no attempt to roll away from that rock and penalized correctly. So, Shanagar.
Absolutely. I think Police will do well to come away with the points here. They've attacked the line. They need to keep doing that and they need to take those 3 points. That's Para coming in off the line. He absolutely needed to make that tackle because otherwise Police were away on that left flank. And he did well to read the situation and come up out of the defensive line.
Credit to the two centers of Police, Mushin and Chola Susanta. They were right on the money right there to secure that ball.
Yes, sir. Good unit, those two, if they can get things going. But there's one criticism of them. It'll be that they're very similar as players. So that may be one aspect that they need to look at.
Sansoni now with the chance to close the gap.
Sansoni now, as the Police grounds, the sopping wet Police grounds comes to a hush for their home team player to bring them within 6 points. And it looks like the kick is good, so Police will score on the stroke of halftime and take a 6 point deficit with them into the halftime break of this first match of the Dialogue Rugby League season. Police plays Navy at Police Park in really difficult underfoot conditions. Here's a replay. Acharige lays it back nicely. And you can see Dinusha Chaturanga there trying to look like he's moving away but using his feet to keep the ball in that ruck. And that's the indiscipline that was punished by Sansoni for that 3 points.
Absolutely, Dinesh Chaturanga knew that he had to roll away. He was trying to do something a little cheeky by slowing that ball down, but referee Rankot gave us right on the money there, penalizing them. So, story of the first half, Navy touching down twice and Police only touching down once, but with the penalty of Rajit Sansoni, has managed to rake up 8 points. Here we go. The action from the first half. This was the first try. There was a double charge there, but referee Rankotge decided that he will go ahead and award that try, Shanaka.
Interesting one. It'll be nice to see a slow motion replay of that, whether there was two touchdowns. Lovely tackle there. And that was the try scored there by Police. Here's Sakti Ranatunga again, thrusting forward. Great pictures here from our camera crew. And that's where the try came for Lee Kegel. A mistake from Sandesh Jayavikrama, the former Pete Wright, playing a fly half for Police in his first club season. And finding out that it's not as easy as it was. These big boys fly up at you.
Definitely, Sanaga, the school rugby is a much faster game, whereas when it comes to club rugby, it's more physical.
If you can look at the first try, the one that was awarded by referee Runcourt, let's see whether it was actually a double movement. We can assume that it was over the line. Here's Sathya Ranadunga, takes it quickly, reaches out, and he doesn't actually lose the ball, Sudarshan. He doesn't lose the ball forward, so all he does is stretch out twice. He doesn't move his body. So I think that might have been okay, because we saw this happen earlier in an international game as well, where TJ Perinara scored a try like that. He lost the ball backwards and then reached out and scored again, and the referee said that was okay, even after consulting the TMO. So I think that try might have been okay, because it didn't look like Sathya Ranadunga moved his body forward off the ground. So it's an interesting one. It's a very interesting one, and it'll be debated for a while, I'm sure, especially by the Police players.
Definitely. So the only concern is that when Sathya Ranadunga is down and he's trying to make the charge, the initial charge, he's being tackled, and it's important that he releases the ball. He can make the initial charge, but not the second time around, Sharaka.
Well, he was stretching out, so I don't know if we can see that again in maybe double slow motion, if we can see exactly what happened. We see the special invitees, the Police, Mr. Hafil Maso on the right.
And interesting for all the rugby fans, Shanaka, the autumn rugby internationals are going to kick off the Dialogue Rugby League, kicked off today. Tomorrow we have three big games, Wales taking on Australia in Cardiff, the Barbarians taking on South Africa in Wembley at the London, and also Ireland taking on New Zealand are looking to extend their winning streak.
Well, they are, but let's not forget Ireland is a team that has come as close to beating them as possible in these last few years. Joe Schmidt is a very astute coach, and he knows exactly what he's doing, so this will be, I think he's probably prepared to forego this game. He'll look at the All Blacks a little bit more closely during this Soldier Field game. He'll look at how they stack up, and he'll actually want to try and do a number of them, number on them in Lansdowne Road when he takes them on the 20th of this month. That's going to be the real key game for Coach Joe Smith. But looking at New Zealand also, I think they're the weaker side that are starting at the moment. When you look at the team that's been put out to play on Soldier Field, we have Waisaki Naholo on one wing, Julian Savea on the other wing. And for me, that's not your greatest wing combination, because they're very one-dimensional. They don't have a guy under the high ball who can help Ben Smith out. Not that Ben Smith needs much help, but still. And you've got Jerome Kano alongside Patrick Tuipulotu in the second row. So that's another interesting one as well. So as we look at the halftime score here, Police, the hosts, 8 points. Navy with 14 points, 2 goals that they have scored. And profiting from the mistake of Jayavikrama just before Police managed to come within 6 points. So just a one score, Police will be happy about that. That'll keep the pressure on this Navy side to keep playing some attacking rugby. So it's wet conditions here at the Dialogue Rugby A Division League. But never mind that, because we're having a hot game despite the water underfoot.
Definitely, luckily enough, the rain has ceased at the moment. We hope that it will stay the same. There will be a little bit of improvement going forward. There you go. That's where you see Shanaka in his raincoat. And assisted by Sabir as well. And talking about the Autumn Internationals and All Blacks playing in a Soldier Field in Chicago, how important is that for the development of rugby and increase of popularity for rugby in the United States?
It's a bittersweet thing, isn't it, Sudarshana? Because I'm a little concerned, being an All Black fan and really being in Asia, about rugby taking off in the US. Because as soon as it becomes a big money sport in the US, that's the end of that. The rest of the rugby world can kiss the World Cup goodbye, because that's when everything goes to pot, for instance. If you've got, I was just thinking about it. You've got LeBron James, who's at 6'10" and one of the most athletic players in the NBA. This guy can dunk. He can move the ball from byline to byline. He's got absolutely no problem athletically. And then you look at guys like Sam White, and he's not the biggest guy in the NBA by a long way. And you've got guys like Ali Williams, you've got guys like Sam Whitelock, you've got your John Eusers of this world, you've got your Martin Johnsons of this world, who at 6'10" are giants on the rugby pitch. And these are guys that, you know, you can tell that they're that big when they're out there. So imagine when you've got a 400-pound linebacker propping against you, when you've got a 7'1" guy jumping against you in the lineup, because you look at Courtney Laws, and he's an outstanding athlete for England. He's just one of those amazing athletes. You look at Mauro Itoje, another really good athlete coming out of England. But Mauro Itoje is going to be one of a hundred when it comes to picking athletes in the USA. You look at Carly Niles, he didn't make the track team, so he was, guess what, I'll play some rugby. And how many guys like that are you going to get out of the woodwork in the US?
Absolutely, absolutely, Shanak. And don't forget all the players who will come from the Caribbeans to the US. They've been losing out a lot of cricketers to the NBA, but at the moment rugby goes pro, we are going to get some giants coming in from there as well.
Absolutely. I mean, you look at a guy like Curtly Ambrose, and he would probably have preferred to play in the NBA, managed to make it in cricket, but if he makes it in rugby, then you're going to be laughing. And with the sprinting power that these guys come back with as well.
And to catch up, log into www.theparpara.com for in-depth analysis of tactics and game plans of Dialogue Rugby League. It will be brought to you by Sabir on the Back to the Boat segment, where he will break down on what teams did right and what teams could have done better. And this will happen weekly, and we will be looking at Dialogue Rugby League. And we are, for all of you who are joining in, the score is 8 points to 12-14. I beg your pardon, Navy in the lead.
Navy looking to start their campaign off with a win. That's our team of officials. Referee Arun Arankutge in the yellow jersey. Hafil Maso on the right, used to be the police coach. Wonderful kicker as well, and used to kick while playing prop.
He is actually the chief guest of the occasion, and there was a felicitation ceremony held for Hafil Maso, a very proud son of the police force, a double international at that. He represented the country in rugby and basketball as well. And today there was a special felicitation for him as he retires from the police force. So senior DIG Hafil Maso. Interesting, we don't get any more forwards, let alone front row forwards, kicking and converting these days, Shanaka.
Well, I don't know, Sudarshan. You look at Dane Coles, a guy can do anything. So I won't be surprised if he says, wait, I'll start kicking as well. If he goes and smacks Bowden Barrett over the head and says, give it to me, I'll do this. He's just amazing. But John Eales is a guy that took a touchline conversion ages ago. I remember maybe in about 2000. He took a touchline conversion to win a game against the All Blacks. And so you've got guys who can do it. It's just that it's got so specialized now that the forwards don't spend a lot of time doing their kicking practice.
When since you did mention Dan Coles, Kevin Mialamu used to be my rugby idol. And when the moment you thought that, okay, fine, there's not going to be a better hooker than that, in comes Dan Coles. It says a lot about the fact that All Blacks do not know the meaning of transition. They look
absolutely
to top it up.
Yeah, because I never imagined that Sean Fitzpatrick and Kevin Mialamu would become redundant so quickly. Nobody's even talking about them because Dane Coles has just destroyed everything in front of him. He's a sevens player, so that's probably why he's got so much skill. He's put about 15 kilos on him. As we wait for Rajita Sanzoni to get the second half of this first match in the Dialogue Rugby League competition underway. And the police in the white taking on Navy at their home grounds. Kicked through by Richie Dharmapala. That's something that they would have talked about at halftime, both the coaches.
And if you're wondering why you cannot spot the numbers on the police jerseys, both teams have turned out to be in white and blue stripes, so the home team had to turn their jerseys inside out, which is why you see police who started the game with white jerseys, they've turned out to be brown and muddy now due to the conditions. Dolanjana with the throw-in for Navy.
Taken at the front. And both teams sensibly playing it short at the line-out.
Rana Singh, a Navy skipper, taking the ball in that time. Oh, a little bit of a fumble, but luckily enough, they managed to drop it back. John Pierce taking the ball in front now, Satya Ranatunga. It's well stolen by Radhish Seniviratna there. But not in control, Lee Kegel runs on the outside and well touchdown for the first points of the second half.
Well, that was important, really important score from Navy, and that's probably going to seal the game as well, because Navy can now play some territorial rugby. See what referee Rankot Gay is asking about here. There was an attempted steal from Radhish Seniviratna. But I think that didn't go to hand, so Kegel, as he did just before halftime, swooped on it.
I believe this will be the first reference. This will be the first reference of the TMO in the club rugby for the year 2016-17. I believe referee Rankot Gay is asking the TMO whether there is any reason why he cannot award that try. Definitely not the grounding. That was absolutely spot on.
Well, it's the first reference in the history of Sri Lankan club rugby, I would think. We've used a TMO in schools rugby, but not in clubs yet. And it's a momentous occasion here in the Dialogue Rugby League that Dialogue have been able to provide that opportunity. And here we go. That's where the steal was. I just picked up. There was didn't look like there was anything the matter with that pickup from Lee Kegel. It was knocked back by Radhish Seniviratna. And Kegel, just as he did in the try before halftime, just swooped on it and touched it down.
The television match official taking his time. He wants to make sure. Again, Seniviratna doing the right thing, but nobody was there to back him up with that steal. There you go. It'll be interesting to see whether Satya Ranatunga knocked that ball on or Radhish Seniviratna was the architect of that steal. I think that's what the TMO is taking a look at. Absolutely brilliant that the referee has the opportunity to check this out without going on a half-hearted decision, Chanaka.
Well, the referee should probably be asking for the side-on angle as well, and on that angle you'll see very clearly that Radhish Seniviratna was the one who stripped the ball from Satya Ranatunga's hands, and he went backwards off Radhish's hands, and that's how Lee Kegel managed to swoop onto it. We see it here. Satya Ranatunga goes down. Watch Radhish Seniviratna in the white jersey. Gets his hands on the ball, and there he does. He scoops it back.
Tough call there. He will take his time to decide on that.
Kicked through again by Kegel, and then he picked it up. So I think that's a try, fair and square.
So no try, says that is the call from the TMO. No try, so Satya Ranatunga seems to have knocked the ball on, and which is why the referee will be bringing back play to the initial point. The television match official Vimal Pereira deciding that Satya Ranatunga lost the ball forward.
Interesting one, because I thought that Radhish Seniviratna had used his hands to strip that ball from Ranatunga's grasp after he had hit the floor. It'll be interesting to see that one again, just on the side-on angle. I think that's the clearest one.
But don't take the credit away from Sene Wiradna for all his hard work. He's the one who made it possible, because he did put his body on the line, wanting to rip that ball off.
Sandesh Jayavikramana does what he should have been doing all this time. Kicked through by Thirana Veerasinghe, who knocks the ball on. Buddhima Piyaratna, in fact, it was. So, good work from Sandesh Jayavikram. He's got to do that more often. Just put the bomb up as soon as he gets it and test this Navy back three.
Police would be finishing a big sigh, really relief there. It was a big blow earlier on in the first half. As soon as the second half started, Navy were away with the try, but has been cancelled out by the first reference of TMO in the history of club rugby in Sri Lanka. Brought to you with the participation of Puffer.com and the SLRFU.
Lovely kick through by Rajita Sansoni. Thirana Veerasinghe does well to cover it. And excellent work in the breakdown as well by Navy.
The assistant referee has his flag up, so he must have spotted some foul play.
Well, it's good that the assistant referees are pointing things out, especially in games like this. You really need your assistant referees as well, because they are so so muddy, you can hardly see anything that happens. Dinusha Chaturanga is going to get the red card. It's a red card. It's a yellow card. Dinusha Chaturanga had his heart in his mouth there. And sanity has prevailed, and it's a yellow card that counts. A good kick through from Chula Susanta. Can see Thirana Veerasinghe picks it up, and we haven't seen
that was, if he was given a red card for that, Chanaka, that would have been a big game changer. But Dinusha Chaturanga would be a very happy man that he ended up with a yellow. So basically now he's gotten a red and a yellow in this game.
Well, all he needs now is a green card, Sudarshan. Appropriately at the traffic police as well. So here's Achala Pereira, Ramesh Acharige. Police going on the blind side quickly. Good work from them to not keep it in the mall too long. Diran Vandakula Surya, they're going on the blind again. Trying to go straight over the top of that, no room there. Nivanka Prasad guarding the fringes like a watchdog. They've got to keep it short now. Sandesh Jayavikrama. Sansoni. Short to Rafaidin. They've gone 20 meters back and they've lost the ball. Unbelievable decision making from Mohammed Absol. Absolutely unbelievable.
Unnecessary there, because they do have the numerical advantage. All they had to do was use the players. Use their forwards close to each other, play 4-5 phases, and then maybe send the ball out, because they anyways have the numerical advantage.
This is incredibly inexperienced rugby from a very experienced player. They've really got to keep it close, move there, split their pack into two, and just attack that line when they're so close to it. Police getting another chance, because it was carried back.
There has been a replacement coming in.
Looks like one of the police players down on the far side of the pitch. It looks like one of their props, Rasit Silva.
Thank you.
Rashid Silva goes off and is replaced at now Muhsin Fakhrul running as he does hard and straight. So many gaps opening up for Mohammed Afzal, not wanting to take one. Sandesh Jayavikram has no options and the ball is turned over. Richie Dharmapala gets the kick in before he is hammered, but the late tackle will be called and another yellow card might just be shown by the referee. It looks like might be Sandesh Jayavikram who gets a card because Richie Dharmapala was absolutely hammered as he cleared that ball from the base of the scrum at the ruck.
Dharmapala on the ground this time. Take a look at the replay.
This is the ball that was really a hospital pass for Sandesh Jayavikram. He had absolutely nobody outside him, nothing to do.
Zal regains the ball but loses possession there.
And it was a ruck after that that the incident happened. We can just see a bit of that. Dharmapala milking it for all it was worth. I think he was winded. This is Muhsin's initial carry. It was a good one here. This is where they needed to consolidate. Somebody picks and goes here. And they've got so much space on the fringes. Afzal should have just attacked that fringe. Here's where he loses the ball forward. That's where it goes forward. And that's where Richie Dharmapala clears it. And just as he clears it, that's where he gets hammered. So I think the referee has chosen not to give the yellow card.
Luckily for Jayavikrama. Unfortunate for police, like you mentioned, Afzal had to keep it close because don't forget they have the numerical advantage still. Dinush Chaturanga is still on the naughty chair.
Didn't well positioned to take the ball that doesn't go out, but once again it's gone forward.
There you go, those are the match officials. Referee Arunaran Kodge assisted by Sarath Madugala and Pradeep Indika as the assistant referees, and the television match official for the first time in the history of club rugby, Vimal Pereira, behind the screens. He's already come once into action and disallowed the first try in the second half by Navy.
Interesting call that one. Dharmapala to Chanaka Chandimal. Buddhima Piyaratna does well to bump off the first tackle. This is good go forward ball from Navy. Now moving it to the short side where all the forwards are stationed. Satya Ranatunga has done a lot of ball carrying. Dharmapala. Nice show and go from Chandimal. Needs to find a pass. Decides to hang on to it. And picked up by Mohammed Afzal. But the referee's whistle had gone before.
Coming in from the side, says the referee. So, no luck there for Afzal.
Well, it'll be interesting to see that one again, Sudarshan, to see whether there was a breakdown that he attacked, or whether it was just a tackle. Did he need to come in from the side there or not? Or did he need to not come through the gate?
Tilavijay Singh has had a trusted boot so far. Two from two, Tilavira Singh rather. He will be looking to have a 100% record this time around. The highest point scorer.
Really burst on the scene at the end of last season. Was a rock for Navy. Scored tries. Safe at the back and put points over as well. The kick is good from Tirunavira Singha, so he restores that 9-point gap. 17 points to 8 now, Navy lead. Can see the run here. It's a lovely run from Chanaka Chandimal. He decides to hang on to the ball, which is probably the smart thing to do. And was there a ruck there? I don't know. Whether there was a ruck there, I'm not sure. So that's an interesting call once again by the ref. There's enough. It was a 50-50 call, I guess.
How about those pictures coming to you from the camera crew? Lovely pictures brought to you by the www.popper.com camera crew, capturing all this action. And don't forget, tomorrow we'll be coming to you live from the Air Force complex in Ratmalale. Air Force taking on Havelocks. Will be an absolutely interesting game that. And also on Sunday, CRNFC will be taking on Army at Racecourse. Army opting to play their home games this time around at Racecourse.
Well cleared there by Navy. Moving it up to halfway from the restart. Good exit strategy from them. All they've got to do now for the next half an hour is just keep the ball in Police's half. Archela Pereira. Acharige goes to the back. And it's stolen. Dharmapala, Chandimal, Satya Ranathunga. They've been using him a lot. Sandesh Jayavikrama gets bounced off not once but twice. That's another big hit going in from Archela Pereira. It's really difficult to identify these players because they've got their numbers turned inside out. Well taken by Sanzoni, who's just at left boot. Chandimal gives it to Veera Singh. The hand comes out to intercept the ball, but just missing. And now Police have a chance to run this one out through. Navy have a chance to run this one out through Piyaratna. Should have given the ball, I thought, when he had the defender committed. And Chandimal puts this into space. Sanzoni. It's a good chase from Police. From Navy, rather. And now Dylan Vandakulu Surya gets a chance to run. Archela Pereira. Dummies. Shows the ball again. Police. Good handling in close quarters here. Archela Pereira. Access come off. Dylan Vandakulu Surya. The Police crowd gets behind its players now. Ahmed Absal attacking the fringe like he should have been doing a lot earlier in the game. Jayavikrama. Here's Police managing to hold on to the ball again. And Udara De Silva stands over it. They've got to pick and go. Archela Pereira. The ball was out. Excellent defense there and well taken by Ranathunga. Basketball pass over the top to his keeper. And the penalty is coming. The ruck was formed, says the referee. And that was great defense by Navy. And again, really poor attacking by Police as well. Once again, using all the wrong options.
That definitely was the best phase of running rugby that we've seen so far in this game. Take a look at the replay. Satya Ranathunga, beautiful basketball pass. Prompted lock forward. But hands inside the rug, Police paying the price.
Radhisha Seniratne is great at the turnovers, but he's also giving away a lot of penalties. That's one part of his game he's got to work on. Think of when to go for it, when not to.
Navy back to 15 men. But Dinesh Chaturanga has been replaced by Sali Handapan Goda. Navy now on the charge. Ranathunga yet again.
You can see what Richie Dharmapala is doing there. He's directing his forwards into the gaps, into the space. Here's Chandimal. Short ball to Piyaratna. Lahiru Herat, in fact. Police defense up quickly. Don't commit themselves. That's great defense from them. Sandesh Jayavikrama making a good tackle there. Police trying to counter-ruck. Dharmapala clears a pressured ball. Satya Ranathunga again full of running. These are conditions that he will enjoy. Here's Handapangoda with a good ball out to the Navy hooker, Dulanjan Vijayaratna, who finds himself on the wing and runs in finally to score a try that Navy would think they should have had at the stroke of half-time.
Definitely so. Good bit of work, like rightly mentioned, Richie Dharmapal making all, although the younger one out here, making all the correct decisions to keep it close time and time again, and his forwards have been backing him up, and Salih Handapan with a fresh legs gives it out to Dulanjana, and nobody's going to stop him from that range. 3 meters out, and he had Chola Susanta to beat, so Navy extending their lead.
Also not great in the defensive alignment. Riza Refaidin came in off his man. He should have trusted that his inside man will do the job. Stefan Gregory coming on for Navy as prop.
How about that? Late into halfway on to the second half, you get 120 kg prop forward coming in with fresh legs to scrum against you. It's the police front rows are not going to like this one, Shanaka.
No, that's not a lot of fun, and it's good to see Gregory. He seems to have leaned up a little bit. Seems much stronger than he was when he was at St. Joseph's. As Sirina Veerasinghe tries to add the extra points to this game, to this try rather.
They mentioned about Gregory having cleaned out. And good kick. Brilliant kick, and this is why this man ended up at the highest point scorer. 4 out of 4 for Stilina Veerasinghe. Brilliant work there. He's already up there as the highest point scorer so far this season, Chanaka.
Well, there'll be a little bit of competition for the other kickers in the Dialogue League. Great hands from Masali Hanapankota. Ran into the gap, committed both defenders, and unselfishly sent Dulanjana Veerasinghe over for the try.
We have 4 games lined up this weekend, and if you do miss the action, catch up what you missed, join Chanaka and Sabir on the breakdown of the Dialogue Rugby League. These two will bring you all what you missed and what to expect in the next weekend. As Chanaka Chandimal kicks deep, good collection by Rajit Sansoni. He's had very good hands so far this game, Chanaka.
Yes, but the police chase has been excellent as well. He had no option but to run into a wall of police chasers, a Navy chasers rather. So used to seeing police playing in the blue, I'm getting confused already. Mohammed Absol, it's a nothing kick once again. And Richie Dharmapala now has a chance to pin police back. The chase is coming, and the chase is good. Jayavikrama is under serious pressure here. The Navy chase is brilliant, and they've overrun this ball. Dharmapala. And it's an easy score for Chanaka Chandimal. And if I was the police coach, I'd get Mohammed Absol off right now.
Absolutely. Absol not having his best game. His decision making has been wary. And like you mentioned, it was absolutely a nothing kick. More than a nothing kick, it was a dangerous kick to the space, because there were no men covering that angle out, and Chanaka Chandimal pouncing on that option. They had a good chase. He did see that white line, and he was always going to go across it.
No chance for Achala Pereira, who was the last defender. Chandimal stepped in off his left foot, straightened up nicely. One of the easier kicks for Thiruna Veerasinghe from this angle, but let's see whether he can make it 5 out of 5.
Thiruna Veerasinghe, he's maintained 100% record today, 4 out of 4. fifth kick at the upright. Oh, this is a player who's put on a little bit of weight, Chanaka.
Yes, Veerasinghe has bulked up a bit. Be interesting to see whether he uses that weight to good effect this season, doing some counter-attacking. And we put the curse on him, Sudarshana.
We definitely have. So the score will remain at 8 points to 29. Navy very much in a comfortable lead. And the contrast of the two halfbacks have been playing telling in this game, Chanaka.
Richard Dharmapala has played a very smart game, Sudarshana. He's used his big forwards around the fringes, used them nicely. And he's chosen the right moments when to give it out. So I think that's been the big difference between the two teams. Both sets of forwards have battled well. And let's see now, with Suranga Pushpakumara coming on, all that experience will make a difference for Police. Good kick return, Stefan Gregory. Making himself a nuisance at the fringe and manages to get the ball turned over for Navy.
You see Suranga Pushpakumar creeping into that ruck.
And going forward, says the referee, so it will be Navy ball. But again, it's a clearance from the base that seemed to be problematic there. And to be fair to Absal, I don't think he's getting a lot of protection for that ball from his forwards. The technique of this Police team may need a little bit of work at the breakdown to try and just secure that ball.
Like you mentioned, when it comes to the Police forwards, you don't see the same cohesion that the Navy forwards have. They are well drilled. You see, especially when it comes to the forwards running into the balls, all the Navy forwards are taking it on the charge, whereas most times they're not. The Police forwards are stationary or not coming into that ball, so making Abzal spin the ball out wide as well. So the forwards are not backing the scrum off up when it comes to Police.
Yeah, definitely. I think that has been the real problem for both these teams. And it's very clear that Navy have adapted better to the conditions. Their game plan has been more sound and the execution has been a lot better.
Like I mentioned earlier, some of these players did make a few calls just before the game to change their boots, because these days most players, even though they are playing in the pack, opt to go for the plastic studs, but these conditions require and demand you to come out with your traditional iron studs, Chanaka.
Yes, and that's good to see. Not many of those boots going around now, and not many players can afford to have a spare pair just for wet conditions. So good to see that they did.
Navy definitely have been the tougher set of forwards.
Real strength and power to this forward pack from Navy. They're probably going to be one of the biggest and meanest forward packs around this entire season. And if games can be won up front, then Navy will be a team that will be really doing some damage at the top of this Dialogue League table. So far, Candy the favourites going in, but it's only the first weekend. And once again, the chase really good from Navy. They know exactly what to do in these conditions. They've kicked the ball forward and just made the kicks really good with their chasing.
That was a brilliant chase there. Take a look at that. Unfortunately for League Eagle, the ball decided to bounce in the other direction. But all credit to the Navy chases, they put their body behind that ball.
Well, he never gives up, does he, League Eagle? just keeps chasing everything. Even if it's in defense, he will keep having a go. Get up and make another tackle if he has to. Good bust up the middle. Lovely pick up from Jai Vikram. And now there's a little bit of space for Police. Picked up, but straight in from the side would probably be the call there.
Yet again, you see that when it comes to the breakdown, especially the rucks, Police ball control has been really messy. They've lost possession time and time again because of that. And the scoreline tells you what's happened.
Yes, 29-8. There's a mountain to climb now for this Police team. And they don't look like they're a team that could be doing that. Buddhima Piyaratna does well to get back. And again, the protection of the ball not very good there.
Two men goes into the rug, but nobody's watching over that ball, protecting it, and getting Navy players able to play that ball. Navy already have scored twice from a similar situation.
Good line out from Police. Nice angle from Falil. And again, as you were saying, Sudarshan, Police coughing it up. And here's some good ball movement. Nicely done. And this is Handapankoda, who'll put his ears back. Handapankoda for the line. Well done by the Police player who got back. That looked like it was Radhi Saseniratna.
And gets back on his feet to hold the ball back. And Stefan Gregory arriving there. He's not able to make a difference, but Salih Handapankoda, he was just flashing away at the ball, Shanaka.
Yes, he did the right thing as well. He kicked it and decided to back his pace. Radhi Saseniratna did really well to get back. Handapankoda is a real speedster. That's the work rate that Rajesh Zeniratna brings to the party.
Beautiful pictures there. Zeniratna absolutely doing the right thing. As soon as he collects the ball, he's not on the ground. He is on his feet. His knees are not touching the ground. If so, he would have had to release that ball. So very good awareness there from Zeniratna.
Short tap awarded to the Police, and Absal takes it quickly. And Musin Falil again lost the ball in contact, and this is the story of Navy's afternoon. A short grubber put through by Pushpa Kumara, can't get to it.
Hands in the ruck, says the referee, and he penalizes the Sailors. So Police will be breathing a sigh of relief, but good work there by Pushpa Kumara again, like you mentioned.
Well, they're doing the right thing, this entire Navy team. They're using their experience. They're putting the ball behind Police and allowing Police to make the mistake. So it's really not it's not rocket science. They're doing it smartly, and they're just waiting for Police to let them in, which is what they've done all game.
Definitely, like you mentioned, Police, they've seen that Police are making mistakes time and time again. So why not let them make the mistakes and capitalize on their mistakes, which Navy have done so far. Navy definitely the more experienced outfit. And catch it on match day on the cricket area. We will be coming to you live from Zimbabwe, where Roshan Abesinghe will be bringing you thoughts at end of the game each day. Cricketery live from Zimbabwe.
Just a difference again. Thirina Veerasinghe had all the time in the world to collect that ball and then put a high bomb, because there was no chase coming from Police. Rafaidin having nowhere to go, so Police just attacking laterally. and Navy happy to escort them out to the touchline.
It hasn't been a very good showing from Police. The first game.
Well, the body language would suggest they've given up the ghost now, Sudarshan, this Police team. And Navy already have the bonus point.
The newly appointed Inspector of Police, Sudhat Sampath, who is the coach for the Police team, will have a lot of words to say soon after the game.
Here's Gregory, his first touch of the game, bumping off the first would-be tackler. Pushpa Kumara. Nice ball movement, but well read there by Seniviratna.
It's really dark here at the Police Park. Although you see a little brighter picture, to the naked eye, it's much darker. So, our viewers having a better view of the game than the people who are at the grounds, to be honest.
Certainly. Most certainly. Pushpa Kumara. Good counter rucking by Police, putting some pressure on the Navy ball, and Pushpa Kumara has had enough of it, puts the ball to his boot and chases, looking to score on his return to competitive rugby. It's a good guy to have on your bench coming on in a game like this, can really keep the opposition guessing, and against that deficit on the scoreboard, he has a license to try things.
And also talking about Pushpa Kumara coming in as the second half replacement, he's a player who's not shy to marshal the troops, to marshal the forwards, especially when they are with heavy legs. He won't be very kind to you if you're not in Iraq. He won't hesitate to maybe smack you and get you out of those ruck situations, Shanaka.
Absolutely not. He's a guy who likes to control his forwards. He's like the mahout behind the elephants. Sradhisa Seniviratna has moved to the back, replacing Diran Vandakula Surya. Nivanka Prasad drives him back 15 meters. Seniviratna gets up and goes again. Absol going in after the ball. Again, no protection for him. Finally gets it and has no option but to throw it back for a clearing kick. And that was a good chase, a much better chase from Police. Rafaidin. Here it is again for Jai Vikrama. Back of the hand offload. That's a nice play from Police. Might be a too little too late. Here's Absol, and again, that hard pass in these wet conditions, really difficult to take. That hard, flat, low pass. Really need something that floats into the receiver's hands.
I do feel for Falil there. He had committed totally for that ball, but it was a little too hard than he expected. So Absol not having the best of games. There you go.
It looks easy enough, but it's a tough ball to take, isn't it, Sudarshan? Especially in this near darkness conditions.
Definitely so. And what Police does not need to do is try to send that ball out wide so far, so soon. What they need to do is try and keep it close, what Navy has done so far.
Pushpa Kumara. Looks like that might have been touched. Rajita Sanzoni running it back. Hasn't had a lot of counter-attacking to do, but once again lost forward in the tackle by Police. Their ball retention has really been pretty woeful in this game. Thirunavira Singha, now you're talking about how he's put on some weight and he looks to counter-attack again. So low to the ground is Radhisha Seniviratna, but the referee says it was a penalty.
that time around, the player going in there and killing the ball, sealing the ball off.
Was Rajita Sanzoni, actually.
He's shown a yellow card.
A little harsh, I think. He didn't stop a scoring opportunity. Not a clear one, anyway. Sanzoni gets hit, then goes back and looks like he was off his feet. So it's definitely a penalty. The ball stays in field, and now police have a little bit of a chance to run. Here's Abzal going across the field and throws a looping ball. Here's police trying to run this one back. And Navy once again just committing more numbers to the breakdown. Police now. It's a knock forward coming from Navy once again. They're throwing it around and trying to create something.
It's really very dark here at Police Park. And mind you, aren't we happy that the game started at 4 o'clock and not 4:30? And our viewers might not be able to determine how dark it is, because the marvel of videography is that they do something to make it look like it, there is very bit of light there. But to the naked eye here at Police Park, it's really very dark.
Yes, it is. If not for the white stripes on Suranga Pushpakumara's back, probably wouldn't see him. Puke feeds. Picked up and going off the back was the Navy replacement. Prasad has gotten a rest. And that's a great turnover from Radhisha Seniratna. Excellent turnover. Gets up and goes again.
That's exactly what Radhisha is capable of, although sometimes it's a fine line when it comes to attacking those rocks. Police now again on the counter-attack. What they need to do is not try and be too expansive.
A little bit of a...
Chula Susanta now gives it out.
Puddhima Pieratna with a ball and all tackle lifted the player off the floor and brought him down safely.
Mushin Falil that time. Pieratna with a hit.
Picking up is Varnakula Surya. And again, the ball lost forward in the tackle.
You can follow the Dialogue Rugby League on www.thepopper.com, where we would be bring you live action, match replays, updates, photographs, analysis, points table, and everything that you need to know about this rugby league. Oh, beautiful tackle there. Brilliant block tackle, losing the ball in contact has been the story of the day for police so far.
Yes, indeed it has. And we need to discuss the man of the match in this first game of the Dialogue Rugby League Championship for 2016-17. And there's been a few players who put their hands up. Lee Keagle has scored a couple of tries. Chanaka Chandimal has been good. Thirina Veerasinghe has got plenty of points. But for me, I think it probably needs to be one of the Navy forwards. I think Nivanka Prasad was very good. Danushka Pereira has done a lot of things in the tight which have gone unnoticed. But I think Satya Ranatunga, with all the ball carrying that he did and the try that he scored early on and the defensive work that he's put in as a prop forward in this game, all the work, he's, I think probably he's the one that I would pick. Sudarshan, up to you.
Like you mentioned, some interesting names coming through there. Lee Keagle did pounce on two occasions where police made mistakes. And one name I thought that was not mentioned was Richie Dharmapala, who was influential in using the forwards. But I would agree with you, Satya Ranatunga. difficult conditions, but he's made some very, very important runs, and I believe he deserves to be the man of the match for the day.
Well, bring a front row forward. The sympathies are with him.
Sata has now converted himself into a lock forward. And mind you, in 2007, when he turned out for Trinity College, he played as the first center. And that is the final whistle.
And that's the end of that. Police lose their first game on their home ground. And Navy get a 29-8 victory, a bonus point victory over the home team. And that's a good marker set down for them, by them rather. And showing that this forward pack really means business. Chanaka Chandimal playing well as Richie Dharmapala. That good halves combination. They've got some experience. They've got a point scorer who can keep the scoreboard ticking over. So the teams, the favoured teams, Havelocks, Kandy, CRNFC, should really be looking at this Navy team and thinking that there will be a very difficult fixture indeed. 29-8, Navy winning.
Absolutely. Spot on, Chanaka, because during the previous, Motilal Jayatilaka, who's the coach at Navy, did not want to be in the first three, did not want to be in the first four. They wanted to win the league. And Navy is definitely going to be a very difficult place to travel. We know how Valisera gets. So Navy, earlier on, sending out the message. And let's take a look at the replays of the game.
Here's Ranatunga with the early try in the rain. I didn't see him move his body, Sudarshana, so I think that's probably okay. He stretched out, it was a little short, and then he managed to get it over. Here's that bit of volleyball. And when you don't want to hold onto the ball in the rain, you're going to concede tries. And that's Police scoring their first try of the game.
Police skipper, the one to score that one. They scored it quickly after the first try.
Here's Ranatunga again, following up nicely. Here's Absal. That pass was not an easy one for Jai Vikramo to hold, and Lee Keagle just kicking that forward, keeping it within his reach and falling over for an easy try. Here he is again. Almost a carbon copy, just had to run a little bit further this time.
This is the one that was not disallowed by the television match official.
Yes, that was the one where the referee they ruled that it had come forward off Satya Ranatunga's hand, whereas we thought in the commentary box that it came backwards off Radhisha Seniviratna's hand. And here's a nice long ball out. Chula Susanta with the kick. And this is where the yellow card came for Dinusha Chaturanga a little while earlier in the piece.
That's when Anurang could get pulled out the red card instead of the yellow, giving all of us a stop, but was quick to make amends.
Here's a run from Chanaka Chandimal, kept it in hand, and this is where the penalty came. Absol going in from the side, and that's where Thiruna Veerasinghe converted the penalty. And here's Sali Handapangoda attacking the line at pace, and Dulanjan Vijayasinghe, the former Wesleyite, going over in the corner. Nice easy run in for him. And Richie Dharmapala, after some excellent work from his forwards, managed to give a long ball out to the back, who'd come in with fresh legs. And it was good work from him. So Richie Dharmapala also playing a key part in this game. And Chanaka Chandimal again being put away by Dharmapala. And that was a try that sealed it for Navy.
Absolutely brilliant performance by Navy, especially taking the conditions into consideration. There you go, the points table, points card for the game. Police see 8 points to Navy's 29. 4 tries, 3 conversions, all 3 coming from Thiruna Veerasinghe. 1 penalty. For Navy and Police with their solitary try.
Well, that brings us to the end of this first fixture of the 2016-17 Championship of the Dialogue Rugby League. Don't forget, we are bringing you Havelocks versus Air Force tomorrow, and then CRNFC versus Army on Sunday as well. We've just kicked off. There's a lot more entertainment to come. This first game has been plenty of thrills and spills, And it should be an interesting season, to say the very least. Thanks for joining us on thepaprae.com and Dialogue TV. We'll be back tomorrow.